Hello guys, Crudeless here. Welcome back to another episode of Let's Play Dark Souls 3. In the last one, we defeated Aldrich, Devourer of Gods. There he is, the head is stuck on the throne up there. And we finished off the area of Anorlondo. We also got the Giant's Coal and we gave it to Andre. Still messing up the name! Andre of Azura. And now, we're gonna continue off down into the Irithyll Dungeons. But before that, there are a couple of things you want to do with the NPC quest lines. First of all, the Handmaiden has now, since we defeated the boss, Aldrich, she has gotten a new item.
Ah, well.
Let's take a look at this one here. So we have the Green Blossom. Previously, we've also found a... take a look at this. Here, let's see. We have a budding Green Blossom here. Flowers of the Green Blossom are ethereal, blossoming only on the surface of chilled but not frozen water. But these are special. The brief attached message suggests that it was a gift. Goodbye, dear grandmother. I will visit grandfather in the Pit of Hollows. Grandfather.
Ashen one.
Grandmother. What is this? Who is she the grandmother of, you say? Well, you remember the Pit of Hollows, where we met Hollow Knight Hodrick, who gave us the Moundmaker Covenant. The Shackles of the Gods. The Moundmakers are blind to those around them, for in their minds, any kill might lead to another shackle. This was all the way back in the Undead Settlement, and I told you guys that you were able to join the Covenant if you didn't go into the cage of that guy, the Nana Cage dude, up in the Undead Settlement. There would be a later chance to join the Covenant, and that is if you have progressed the series of the Sunless Realm questline. Now, don't warp to... I know what you're thinking now. Don't warp to the Pit of Hollows. You want to warp to the Cliff's Underside. Because there is... we gotta help Ceres again. That's what we have to do. So we have to hop into her world again and help her out, just like we did back in Irithyll of the Boreal Valley. And by doing this, we will finish off the questline for Ceres. Oh, this is like the... Oh, I lost a lot of health there. Oh my god. But yeah, this is like the last part of Ceres' questline. And the only way to mess this up is to not help her, of course, but also by joining Rosaria's Covenant. So once we have finished this one off, we'll be able to join Rosaria's Covenant without any repercussions. What are these signs here? Great curse-ridden tree ahead. I'm playing in offline mode, so this is strange. A transposing kiln lies within the belly. So these are developer messages, actually. But here you see the summon sign for requesting cooperation. Answer series of the Sunless Realm call. Yes, we will. And now we'll be transported down into her world, into the Pit of Hollows. And she's here to see her grandfather.
I finally found you. Just as I promised, Grandad. Remember?
Now, we remember his dialogue. He told us he was going hollow, or at least he pretended to, like us. And Ceres, she is using she has the Dark Moon loyalty gesture. She's a member of the Dark Moon Covenant. She fights the hollow. Oh my god, he parried us! Oh my god, I didn't expect that one. Yeah, if we die here, we'll be just ported out. And we will be able to go in here again and fight him off, basically, without any... Not a lot of, effort. Oh, he parried us again? He's such a crazy... I should be focusing on backstabbing this guy while he, I guess, Ceres has his attention. Come on. I've used up all of my Essence Flasks now. I'm really terrible at PvP, by the way, if you can tell. We could try to parry him, though, but I don't have the freaking shield on me. Do I? Let's get that one equipped. Come on, can you tank, please? Let's equip the target shield. That's better. Can we parry him now? Let's not make him let him use that one. Oh, try to bait his attack there. As you can see, he's like more dangerous than Aldrich. He's a lot more dangerous. Why is he so good? Oh my god. Okay, we gotta let Sirius fight him for a bit. Can you tank him, please? I wanna get some backstabs. I wanna get some backstabs. There we go. That's the easiest way of taking him down. But he has so much health. Oh my god. So much health. Can I parry him now? I tried to at least, but I couldn't. Now he's trying to use Power Within, which make him his attacks deal a lot more damage, but he will take even more damage as well. So he has that healing thing, which is kind of nice. Let's not let them heal up, though. There we go. All of this is flasks. Oh my god, that was the hardest boss fight in the game up until this point.
Good night, Granddad.
Now we spawn back here, and then we wanna... Oh, I don't think it's a good idea to jump down here, but you can see the pit of hollows below. We haven't seen this view here yet. But he apparently went hollow, and Sirius basically... Well, I think that's my interpretation at least. She freed him from his hollowing process. And she said goodbye to her grandmother. And this was his granddad. Or her granddad. Interesting. Let's have a chat back at the Shrine Bonfire and see what Sirius has to say to us, as she will meet us back here now. If you want to join the Covenant, by the way, you can do that just by... I think you get the Shackle by killing him. So you'll be able to turn in those mount things there back in the Pit of Hollows.
Oh, there you are. I'm afraid I've involved you in my affairs over a little promise at that. My sincerest thanks for your assistance. At last, my grandfather will rest in peace, and I can die. But there is one last, may I take a vow, to serve you as a knight.
Now, this won't really have any repercussions at all, so you might as well accept her knightly vow.
Oh, I am most grateful. I, Cirrus, do hereby serve as your faithful knight. Wherever, whenever I am needed. My loyalty shall never waver. Blessing of the moon upon your journey. If I may ever be of assistance, I am your knight.
As you can see there is some dialogue that cuts out, basically. I don't think there is either some errors with the voice lines or with the coding there. But now she has basically vowed to be our knightly fellow, and if we attack her now, she won't fight back. So you can kill her to get her equipment right now, but you will be able to get her equipment later on. Killing her now won't count as a sin either, so yeah, you're basically done with her questline. You can also join Rosarius now without her being pissed at you, which is really nice. Before we do anything else though, you want to reload the area. You can do this by either quick clicking on the exit by quit game, or you can just rest here at the bonfire and select the Firelink Shrine here once more. Because there is something that happens once Sirius leaves. As you can see, she's now gone from this place. I don't think her grandmother even comments on this. And no, she doesn't.
Ashen one, if my wares are not to thy satisfaction, bring me with...
One interesting thing to note, though, was that we gave her the Dream Tracer's Ashes from Farron Keep. By the way, just wait for this to remove. And we gave her that. That made Ciri spawn for the first time. And it was about the person that chased after some dream of sorts. And Sirius apparently did that, perhaps. That's why the Handmaiden commented on it. I can't really remember what the description was right now. But if you play through, you should probably notice that. As you can see now, there is an item here, down by this guy, and this grave. The Sunset Shield. Now this is the shield for Hodrick. Let's equip a torch here, just for the sake of having that one. Just like to have it equipped. Let's take a look at the shield, the Sunset Shield. Really interesting that Holy Knight Hodrick had this one. Holy Knights of the Sunless Realm. So he was a holy knight of the Sunless Realm. That's why it was Holy Knight Hodrick. Engraved with a brilliant flame crest that burns brightly within the Order's customary sunset colors. This design symbolizes those who both harbor and oppose the power of flame. Really nice shield as well. Good stats overall. And it opposes and finds usage in the fire, the Sunless Realm. Sunless Realm is, of course, a realm with no sun. It's a realm that's consumed by the dark. Which is interesting why he is a holy knight of a Sunless Realm. There is another questline that we have can't finish right now. We should do that as well before we head down into the... what is it called? The Distant Manor. There are lots of these questlines that we are wrapping up now, basically. We also have... lone dude sitting here in the I guess Sigurd is down in near the Distant Manor still in the kitchen. He won't leave there until you visit the next bonfire after the Distant Manor, so he's still there in the kitchen, which is really funny. But yeah, let's go to Rosaria's bedchamber here, as she is directly tied to Gvinevir that we saw in the previous episode. Well, we saw her ring, at least we saw the Sun Princess ring, and we talked about the divine blessing and the daughters of Gwyn. Now, you can see some similarities here to the room, this, like, here. This room is really similar to the room behind Aldrich. Very similar. And we talked about Gwyndolin being a Gwynevere. Oh, these names are so similar. See the hair here basically going so long, man. Being a goddess of fertility and bounty, Gwynevere, that is. According to this room, there are lots of these beds. Might be an indication that this one is also referred to or related to fertility and bounty. Perhaps this is Gwynevere? But I don't think it is. It might be one of her daughters, or it might be someone else entirely. But what we can do now, as you can see here, nothing special, nothing is going on. But we do have one of these tongues. Claiming tongues as trophies was originally the practice of an infamous troop of invaders who offered them to their speechless goddess. Let's give her one. Come on, talk to me. She won't talk to me. There we go. Now, we can alter our appearance here, reallocate attributes if you want to respec, or we can just offer tongues. Offering tongues will increase our rank in the Covenant. We can get some miracles and stuff, but I'm just going to offer one. She looks towards us and look back towards her slug-looking thing. Is that a part of her body or is it just part of something else? Can't really see that. But once you do, look who is here. Leyenheart, the Ringfinger. Let's have a chat. If that guy doesn't come for us, he's really slow though. But he is coming for us. Can he go in here? I don't think he can.
Ah, so you've chosen to serve Rosaria after all. She will be pleased with me for finding her another finger. But be warned, my friend. Rosaria's fingers need only fetch tongues for their mistress. Otherwise, we are free, unchained. Like Yellowfinger, you can choose to believe that all fingers share camaraderie. But do not force your romance upon the rest of us.
First of all, like Yellowfinger. You remember Yellowfinger, right? She was wearing this thing. We fought her back in the Crucifixion Woods. Santhus clothing of is a mark of a researcher of lust sorceries. And the oversized crown is emblematic of their work. A curious pursuit, surely nothing to be ashamed of. She apparently was... seeking friendship in fighting and invading others. Or friendship, at least, yeah. Well, she was a descendant of the clerics or followers of the Farron defenders, and then she turned to Rosaria and became a finger, Yellowfinger Heisel.
Rosaria's fingers need only fetch tongues for their mistress. Otherwise, you are free to believe, but do not force.
Do not force our romance upon you. If you rest here now, I think something will happen as well, since we have defeated Aldrich. I think we have to reload the area. So let me just do that, and then we'll be back into business. Back in business. So, as you can see, he's now gone. But we will have to wait with continuing his quest line, because he will finish it off when we have defeated the last Lord of Cinder, which is Yorm the Giant. He is probably the only place we haven't visited, Distant Manor. So let's head over there and start the show. So we are back in Irithyll, and by the way, be prepared now, because there will be a really difficult, well, it might be a difficult NPC invasion coming up. More of these guys here. As you can see, they are trying to trap you by moving, going down the stairs. And there will be like an ambush there coming from the left, as you can see, a Pontiff Knight. So that's why they are kind of distracting you from doing that. Come on. Take this.
Take this.
Another crown, really? I want the armor, though. There will be a quite a difficult NPC invasion there. I don't think there is anything over here at all. There's just an ambush there. More of those pyromancers, as we've seen them before. These flame witches of the profane flame. We gotta go back to Pontiff Sullivan now, because they're, or discussing him at least, what he's about to do, because the. Well, the stuff we're going to find now basically is it involves a lot of the profane flame stuff, which I have to admit that I'm not really as comfortable discussing the profane flame, because it really, really is obscure and difficult for me to understand it. I don't think there's anything over here. I don't think there should be a hidden passage, but there's only those mobs here. So, but yeah, profane flame. As you said, as we heard previously on the description of one of the swords that we could transpose, Aldrich built the city here, well, we at least think he did, based on that he found the profane flame down below. And we also remember that Sigurd talked about a promise he made to a friend down below the Irithyll dungeons. Here we have Oliva, Seeker of the Spurned. Oliva, of course, is using one of the most amazing armor sets in Dark Souls 2. Oliva's armor. Man, that poise. I guess hyper armor of sorts. Enemies do have poise. We don't, so. She's using like a big crossbow, and she's using a giant curved greatsword. Though it's easy to dodge around that. I'm saying she. I do think Oliva is a he in this case. Physically, it looks like that. But we will get some amazing stuff here. We get the Murakumo, and we'll also be able to buy the equipment there, which looks freaking amazing. But yeah, we got the Murakumo.
Murakumo, what is it?
What is the Murakumo? It's a curved greatsword, so it should be up here next to the greatswords, right? There it is. The curved greatsword of Oliva, Seeker of the Spurned, specially forged in an eastern land, sharp but heavy. This sword requires extreme strength and dexterity to wield. The search for the Spurned had no end, and so the wayfaring knight warmed to a most deformed weapon. Spurned, huh? As you can see here, there looks to be a path down here, but it ends briefly, instantaneously. Might be because the world is shifting, of course. Maybe this place here, the Irithyll Dungeons, has shifted to be further down. Maybe it was supposed to be further up. Not certain there, but as you remember, the world, the geography of this, of Lothric is quite difficult to comprehend. So if you rest at the bonfire here, if you just activate this one, then Sigurd will be removed from the kitchen in the Irithyll Boreal Valley place. So if you haven't sent out Grey Rat already, then yeah, you gotta do all that and defeat a boss before you light this fire. Baby, can you light my fire? Let's do that. As you can see here, this place, really reminiscent of a place in Dark Demon Souls, actually. If you go back and watch my old Let's Play of that one, then it's not old, it's not that old, it's from January or something of this year. But we visited a place called the Tower of Latria. Probably my favorite zone in any of the Souls games. And this one is an asshole, by the way. Yeah, dicky move right there. You just get a rusted coin. Rusted coins are also kind of like a trick thing that they do, because it's, let's have a look at this thing. like those who have lost their fortunes rely upon this superstitious practice, hoping to retrieve what was once lost. He also got a rusty gold coin. Have we checked this one out already? A rich man lost his fortune, but it returned to him twofold. He was swift to squander his retrieved fortune, smugly confident that it was bound to double once again. Something about greed there. But yeah. Not much about these rooms, to be honest. Some of them are locked, some are not. You can see some jailers on the opposite side. These jailers are freaking annoying, by the way. This one is locked, I believe. Yes, it is. And this one is open. The enemies in this area kind of work like the Tower of Latria ones, but these do have a curse aura. You can see my health will start to rapidly like degenerate if I let them do their moves. By the way, this is a trap as well. If you approach the item there, this dude will move forward and push you down, trapping you. So you can roll past this, he will try to push you, and you can stab him in the back, pretty much, and chunk him into the wall. Bye-bye. What can I... I'm hearing lots of sounds here. You can, of course, just jump down there. There isn't a lot of things to do there, to be honest. There is a couple of items that we want to get, so... I'm going to clear this area out 100%. And we'll probably... It'll probably take until the... At least into the next episode as well. Just want to show you guys the entirety of this place. It's not as great as the... Ah, come on. What happened to him? He went through the wall? What? As you can see, these guys are spouting this curse-looking thing. Look at my health now. Yep. And after a while, it will basically be full again, but I will have lost all that health, as you can see. This is also one of those screaming guys, so if you want to, like, shut off your earphones or close your ears. Close your ears for a moment. Then, yeah. Behind him, we can see some... Some grandiose stuff down there. What is this? What is this foreshadowing? And the door is locked, of course, so we gotta get a key for a shortcut. The path we were supposed to take is over there, across the bridge where we killed these two guys. Now you can see my health is halfway drained. Man, we need some more undead bone shards to improve our essence flask. We have so much health now. And a good thing I brought the fire enchant on our weapon here, because the cages, as you can see, are weak to fire. These guys are pretty weak to fire as well, it looks like. These guys, pretty weak to fire. Good thing I brought that along. Okay. Let's get. Oh, I did the backstab there. I didn't mean to do that. Backstab, I mean. And there is another item here that we can't get either. It's locked, so we have to get back with a key. Or a couple of key, in fact. Oh, a couple of key, in fact. As you can see, this guy as well. He actually had one of those leech bodies coming out of him, so it's another trap. So you want to bring a torch here as well for those leeches to be able to remove that. But we have to get a couple of key. This one isn't coming to life, no. So tricky of these guys to have someone coming back to life, and some of them don't at all. Yeah, having a fire weapon here or a torch or something really, really handy against those enemies, the leech guys. And this is kind of a funny reference. This is the sorcerer set. Back in Dark Demon Souls in Tower of Latria, which was a big prison area, I recommend that you check that one out because that area is freaking amazing. This one is good as well, but it's nothing compared to Tower of Latria's atmosphere. Traditional attire worn by sorcerers of the Vinheim Dragon School. Long ago, sorcerers were said to always dress properly, even while on distant journeys of discovery, even before such journeys were established curriculum. The reference is, of course, was a old wizard trapped in the Tower of Latria as well. Where is it? Where is it? I can't even find it here. Yeah, well, guess it doesn't matter. I'm just blind, I guess. Oh, there it is. Long ago, sorcerers were said to always dress properly. Yep, they were on a trip here, apparently, and he got captured. Wonder what that was all about. You can see some more of these leechmongers, as I call them. Really weak to fire. You can just hit this guy through the fence. And he drops the great magic shield spell. Here it is. sorcery which improves upon magic shield, greatly reinforces left shield with magic. Only sorcerers or swordsmen with special duties are permitted to use the use of the spell, which temporarily grants even the smallest of shields fortitude more akin to that of a great shield. Really amazing spell, really great. You want to bring that one along with you if you're going to be using sorceries or a shield. So you can see the similarities already with the cages here. You can draw lines between Pontiff Sylvan, who's... We could assume that Pontiff Sylvan is using this here as a like a cage, a dungeon, of course, to prison, keep prisoners, but also to experiment upon them. You have the cages down there with all the people inside. You have the leech people, and we can see some other things that he's also been experimenting on, which are interesting. And his jailers, of course, and yeah. You want to avoid those guys here. You don't have to go to the end. There will be an ambush to the left there. You can see that guy. He's inside here. I don't think it was him. There is another one, though, that will ambush you. More Titanite shards. Let's stabby him. Oh, I'm talking about the floor underneath here. This place is really disorganizing. It's easy to get disoriented here. The door, by the way, at the other side here is locked, so it's a shortcut for later on. Here.
Does it open from this side?
You gotta get around there. So you want to take the first to the left here and move through here. And you want to look closely here. To our right. You see this guy? Yeah, this guy? He's not looking too good. But he won't really do any harm. The latest one you find, however, that looks like this will do. Interesting thing about this guy is you can see those things on his back. Those things right next to my torch now. Those really look like small dragon wings. Well, they don't look like dragon wings now, but you'll see some similarities. You can see how he has grown a tail of sorts. So he almost looks like he's starting to turn into something like a lizard. Interestingly enough, what has Pontiff Sylvan been doing here? What has he been doing? We know where he was from. He was from... I think we know where he was from, at least. He was from the... from Lothric. I don't think there's a trap here. Nope. Just a Dalebreaker's key. This is the one we need for something later on. This does not open the doors we've been through already, I think. Key to the buried window in the Irithyll dungeon. So this is a shortcut next to the screaming thing back on the other side. But the window only leads to a bottomless black pit below and above, paltry view of the ruined, profaned capital. The very architecture appears to be a cruel joke the jailers played on the would-be escapees. A cruel joke they played on the escapees. Down here, there will be more of those jailer frickin' fricker. So I'm gonna get these guys down as quickly as can. There'll be more of them, as you can see, and they do stack their freaking annoying thing. They also have those things, and they stun you and burn you to death, and then you'll be, oh my god, oh my, no, I shouldn't have rolled out there, I should have rolled back, I forgot about those two guys. Oh my god. So what I was saying was that there was something about the architecture. And you want to take care of these guys without being attacked by two of them at the same time, because they will gang up on you and stab you with their freaking burning irons, and you'll be in big trouble, man. But yeah, I think you can. Yeah, you can pull this guy to the left before the other guys approaches. My god, look at her health here. I'm not sure what that is. I think it's maybe his. Maybe it's his lamp he's holding in his right hand that glows, perhaps. There isn't a clear indication as to what gives them the power, but they do drop a ton of souls. This guy will attack you. So you want to stab him down quickly. And we got a simple gem. I don't think we have one of those yet. Yeah, we have one already. It created a simple weapon. Now we know that these two frickers will try to kill us. So let's get our revenge. At last we can have our revenge. And this one... is of course closed. almost cleared out the entire area here, so I'm going to finish off and we're going to move towards the end. Let's get this one before we get attacked by the ambush. Of course there's an ambush, as you can see. Got two birds with one stone there, though, which is really nice. We got a Titanite scale from him, and this guy's not too happy. Let's open the door and kill him. Don't think there is any benefit to that, to be honest. Let's put an end to his suffering. Put an end to his suffering. I heard some noises there. What was that? Not sure. But there is an item up there that we can get if we jump down through the window. I think we are going to... I'm going to cut to when we're up in the window just to show you guys how to get that one. So we make our way back to the starting point, and then we go out the door with this freaking screaming annoying dude. And then we'll be just outside. Make sure you have some health and jump down. We get the Bellowing Dragon Quest Ring. The Bellowing Dragon Quest Ring. We have the Lingering Dragon Quest Ring that we found from the big crab in Farron Keep. This one has the same description, actually. A bellowing dragon symbolizes the true nature of the consummate sorcerer. Lingering dragon symbolizes the true nature of a consummate sorcerer. So which one is it? Which one is the true one? This dough, it boosts sorceries. This one extends the length of spell effects. So they are a bit different. Special ring given to those who are deemed fit to undertake the journey of discovery in Vinheim. So they went on a journey. Now from here on, you can jump down to kill this guy, who is basically pretty well hidden. There are more of these down there. Let's kill these two folks. And they do use bleed weapons and bleed shots. As you can see, these are actually prisoners. Or not prisoners, but they are basically wardens. They have the same mask as the guy above. Guys above, more precisely, with the irons. Now, let's get a view of this place. Let's get the item first, though. Homeward Bone. So here we see the profaned capital. We see a path going out there towards this building that we saw. And then we see a fire down there. This place is really amazing, by the way, if you just look at this. See the solar flares beaming through there. Down below into this giant building. And that's where we're heading, down to the flame. Down there. Hope you guys enjoyed the episode. Got a death in this one. Not faring too well. But we will continue down into the profane capital in the next episode. So I hope you guys... Hopefully I'll see you guys then. And take care until next time. Thank you so much for watching. Bye-bye.